Without further ado, will you please join me in a warm Lenoir-Rhyne University Nation welcome for the head football coach of Lenoir-Rhyne, Mike Houston. Mike.
Thank you. To say that I'm excited about this opportunity would be a massive understatement. I've been preparing for this job for a while. I'm grateful to be standing here today as the new head football coach at Lenoir-Rhyne University. I felt for some time now that God led Amanda and I to Hickory, North Carolina, and to Lenoir-Rhyne. He's blessed us greatly since arriving here, including the birth of our son, Owen. And this fall, Amanda and Owen will be the biggest Bear fans there are around and throughout the year. And anyone that's ever met our son knows he'll be enthusiastic with his support. I want to thank the president of Lenoir-Rhyne, Dr. Wayne Powell, and our athletic director, Neil McGahee, for their confidence in trusting me with this position. I also want to say a special thank you to Fred Goldsmith, who's been a friend, mentor, and leader that I was very fortunate to work for and with for the past 4.5 years. Coach Goldsmith has meant a great deal to me and to everyone else in this program, and we'll always be grateful for everything he's done for us. Moving forward, I have tremendous confidence in the players on this football team and in the incoming freshman class this staff has recruited. They're talented athletes, good students, and outstanding young men. I'm excited to be their head football coach. I think we have a solid and cohesive coaching staff. They are hardworking, knowledgeable men of integrity, and they will have this team playing at a very high level when we kick off September the 3rd in Athens, West Virginia against Concord University. We had a productive spring, and everyone in our entire program is enthusiastically preparing for this upcoming season. And we can't wait to get started. Thank you.
As Coach was saying, I'm speaking for the whole team. But first off, we want to definitely say thank you to Coach Goldsmith. He's been a great influence on our life and his football program. He's brought us back to a position where we can compete and win. But now I want to just say, all of us want to say congratulations to Coach Houston. We're excited about having him. We all honor and respect him, and we're going to follow him into battle just as we would have Coach Goldsmith. And I'm excited about it, and I think he's definitely the right guy for the job. And next season is going to be fun and exciting, and I know he's going to push us and work us hard, maybe harder than Coach Goldsmith, which I'm looking forward to. But, I mean, it's good to have you, Coach. We appreciate it.
When you came here a few years ago, was this on your target of where you want? I mean, obviously you want to become a head coach, but this sure. Soon here at this institution?
Yeah, I mean, this is obviously was a career goal of mine. And, you know, in talking to Coach Goldsmith whenever he first took this job and after doing some investigation into the support here at Lenoir-Rhyne, I think this is a really good place. And, you know, Hickory, North Carolina is a great town for a family, and so yeah, this is a place that I definitely wanted to be.
Changes that we can expect from what Coach Goldsmith did, X's and O's wise?
There's obviously going to be some personal influence in every phase of our program. That being said, we have recruited for the current offensive and defensive system that we run, so any tweaks along those lines will be fairly minor. Probably most of the changes will be just in philosophy of practice or you know, the way we go about certain other phases of our program. We do, and talking with our special teams coordinator, Coach Harrell, this morning, you know, we're really focused on trying to improve in that area for this fall. And feel like we have some really talented kids there to help us do that.
Will you continue to be a defense coordinator?
Yes, I will. You're probably the biggest difference in Coach Goldsmith and I as we're at in our careers. You know, obviously, there was a time when he was much more focused on the field coaching, being more hands-on with the players than he was at the end of his career. And that's where I'm at right now. You know, some of the most enjoyable times that I have in coaching are at practice with the players and being involved in different drills and different things on the practice field. And I don't want to give that up. I think that that's something I definitely want to continue to do. So that's going to require, a lot more influence and input from our other assistants on defense, which I have tremendous confidence in. And so I think with their using their abilities, I'll be able to serve in both roles.
Stepping stone to even better things as far as last season's record is concerned. And I wonder if you might comment on that sort of pressure.
Well, I mean, every head coach in the United States feels pressure to a degree. I embrace the tradition of Lenoir-Rhyne, and it does have, the championship banners hanging out in front of our stadium. I mean, every time you walk by them, you're reminded. There's a picture on the wall behind me. There's trophies around celebrating the 1960 national championship team, and you know, so there's obvious things here, exhibiting the tradition that Lenoir-Rhyne has, and we hope to add to that. Last year was a great stepping stone back towards that after too long of a drought. At the same time, last year's over and done with, and that's not going to help us any next fall when we tee it up. And what's going to happen then is going to be decided by our players primarily over the next 2 months and what kind of shape they report in the fall. But, the goals of this program every year that I'm the head coach here will be the same, and our goal is to win the South Atlantic Conference Championship this fall, next fall, and the fall after that. So most of the pressure that I'm going to feel is going to be self-inflicted.